Well, developing now in a new move, Baltimore City will no longer use gag orders in police settlements.
Paul Gessler reports what led to this point and why some say the new policy does not go far enough.
You can't give a person a gag order when they've been victimized.
Mayor Jack Young announced he signed an executive order last week allowing those who have settled claims against the city to speak out.
It was three male officers who beat, punched, kicked, and attacked me as if I were a male or a threat.
The gag order executive order comes after Ashley Overbay and the Maryland ACLU successfully sued the city, and a federal court ruled the non-disclosure agreements unconstitutional.
Unless the people can know what's going on and what these cops and the government and city officials are actually doing to us, no change can come about.
The city had revoked half of Overbay's settlement after she spoke out online, citing a violation of her NDA.
Which have silenced numerous victims, maybe more than we know.
Young says he met with Tawanda Jones, an outspoken activist against police brutality, after her brother Tyrone West died in police custody in 2013. The executive order applies retroactively to all those who have settled claims against the city.
That anybody who sues the city and win should be able to talk about it and talk about it truthfully.
The ACLU wants city council to pass legislation on top of this executive order to bar NDAs in city settlements. In Baltimore, Paul Gessler for WJZ.